International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses to decide a name for the new coronavirus. There are guidelines set to decide on the new name after infecting thousands and causing worldwide tension. The new coronavirus will get a new name. Scientists are trying to find a name for the new strain of the virus. Even after being discussed on various platforms, the new virus doesn't have a proper name that was officially assigned to it. The name coronavirus is referred to identify the virus, but it is the name of the group of viruses it belongs to. The temporary name that was given to the virus by the WHO is 2019 nCoV. The name comes with reference to the year it was discovered, and nCoV is basically saying the novel coronavirus. This name is being considered too much of a mouthful to be used, so everyone has resorted to calling it the coronavirus. The names and social tensions. The assigning of a new name is associated with the social tensions that could possibly arise from it. The science community and the media were focused on the patients and controlling the spread of the virus. The present focus of the need for a new name came after people started calling it China virus and Wuhan virus, which has caused racial tensions in several parts of the world. Since most of the discussions happen on social media, there are chances of unofficial names taking hold and not being able to reverse the effect of the name. The task to formally assign a name is designated to the International Committee on Taxonomy of Viruses, ICTV. There are several things that the team assigned to picking the name for the virus has to be cautious about. When the H1N1 virus or swine flu outbreak took place, people were mistaken that the disease comes from pigs. In Egypt, pigs were slaughtered because of this. Even official names were sometimes problematic, like the Middle East Respiratory Syndrome or MERS. There were a lot of social biases and prejudices that happened because of the name. Guidelines for deciding the new name. Since there has been backlash before the assigning of a new name will be done carefully. According to the guidelines said, the name will not include geographical locations, people's names, the name of an animal or a kind of food, and references to a particular culture or industry. The name will be short and descriptive. Some experts who will be deciding the name said that the name needs to be hooked for it to be used extensively. The discussion for the name began 2 weeks ago and took 2 days to settle into a name. The new name will be seen in a scientific journal after its submission, which will announce the name in a few days. Passenger dies aboard flight from China to New Zealand. Is coronavirus the cause? A passenger died midair on a flight bound from China to New Zealand, sparking fresh fears of coronavirus. A passenger died aboard an inbound flight to New Zealand, Auckland from China, which has sparked off fresh fears of coronavirus. The death occurred aboard a China Southern Airlines flight CZ305 from Guangzhou that landed at the Auckland airport. Unfortunately, the passenger had passed away before arrival to Auckland airport, said a spokesman to NZ Herald. The police reached the spot and confirmed they attended a report of sudden death on the inbound flight, which was reported to be around 4:30 p.m. on Monday, New Zealand time. Death is not due to coronavirus. Panic spread among other flyers and airport authorities that the death might be due to coronavirus, but a spokesperson confirmed that the passenger died of other cause and not of coronavirus. The death is believed to have been due to a medical event and is not believed to have been related to coronavirus. The death comes after heightened travel restrictions aimed at preventing the deadly coronavirus from reaching the shores of other countries. Since last week, many countries have barred flights from China and have cancelled all approved Chinese visas until further notice. Economists predict that China's economy might fall if the virus is not contained and might cause severe job losses. The virus is now a worldwide crisis. Coronavirus has spread its evil wings around the world, and multiple countries such as India, Japan, Vietnam among others confirmed they've diagnosed victims, and several others are quarantined and kept under observation. There has been more than 400 deaths alone in China due to the deadly virus, and more than 24,000 cases have been confirmed, and the numbers are only increasing by the day. The Chinese government confirmed they're calling for an improvement in the country's emergency management system and provide better care and treatment for those affected. Coronavirus has spread in 28 countries in just a month. Nations cancelling flights to China. Coronavirus, which emerged in China's Wuhan province, has now reached 28 countries and 4 continents in just a month. Coronavirus, which started in China's Wuhan province, has spread its deadly wings across the globe in 28 countries and 4 continents in just a month. Governments across the world have sent out precautionary measures on how to not get affected by the virus, which includes avoiding frozen meat, washing hands regularly, wearing face masks, and not shaking hands. Despite the best efforts to contain the virus which emerged from China, it has spread far and wide, and the 28 countries that have confirmed cases are China, India, Nepal, Sri Lanka, United Arab Emirates, Russia, Vietnam, Thailand, Cambodia, Malaysia, South Korea, Japan, Taiwan, Philippines, Hong Kong, Macau, Singapore, Australia, Italy, Finland, Sweden, Germany, Belgium, United Kingdom, France, Spain, Canada, and the United States of America. The four continents that coronavirus has reached are Asia, Australia, Europe and North America. Continents such as South America, Africa and Antarctica luckily have not been affected by the virus yet. International flights to and from China cancelled to contain the virus from reaching the shores of other countries. Nations across the world have cancelled all international flights to and from China and all approved visas have been rejected. Those who travelled from China for business and holidays have been quarantined at their respective homeland and kept under observation at hospitals. Also, more than 6,000 people are being quarantined on two cruise ships off Hong Kong and Japan amid concerns that passengers along with crew members might have been inadvertently exposed to coronavirus. People aboard both the ships are being given health screenings and those with suspicious symptoms are being held and getting tested for the virus. As of February 5 evening, 33 people working on board the ship claimed to have developed symptoms of upper respiratory tract infections and 3 people who had fever were sent to the hospital for isolation and management. The rest of the passengers will be held on the ship for 14 days, as required by the Ministry of Health, the cruise company's statement said. China accused of secretly burning bodies of coronavirus victims. World health officials expressed grave concerns that China is hiding the official numbers of those who died from coronavirus. World health officials who returned from the Chinese capital Beijing expressed great concern that the regime is hiding the number of coronavirus-affected victims and is also not honest about the death toll due to the outbreak. The officials claimed that Chinese authorities have been cremating bodies in secret and said bodies were being sent directly from hospitals to cremation centers without being properly identified and added to the official record. William Yang is skeptical about the death count. William Yang, correspondent of DW News East Asia, skeptical about the death count, said, "So there are reasons to remain skeptical about what China has been sharing with the world because while they have been more transparent about certain things related to the virus, they continue to be sketchy and unreliable in other aspects. Also, one thing that #China is hiding is the number of deaths caused by the virus." Credible Chinese media outlet at Anisham News interviewed people working at local cremation centers, confirming that many dead bodies were sent directly from the hospitals to the cremation centers, and followed it up with seriousness of the spread in #China, but also the lack of facilities that can handle the rising number of patients, tweeted Yang. Yang also shared an image on Twitter on how the Chinese government is curtailing information about the virus after they detained prominent activist Hu Jia as he was invited to speak about the epidemic to a foreign media outlet. This is how #China tries to control information about #Wuhan coronavirus outbreak, arbitrary detention of prominent activist Hu Jia simply because he was invited to talk about the public health crisis on a foreign media outlet. The detention has no legitimacy except. However, on a positive note, the World Health Organization's emergencies chief told reporters that China was taking extraordinary measures in the face of an extraordinary challenge posed by the infectious outbreak. Coronavirus crisis goes global. Coronavirus, which started in Wuhan, China, has spread across the globe and countries like India, Japan, Singapore, Vietnam and Taiwan have confirmed cases and several others have been quarantined and kept under observation. International flights to and from China have been suspended by many countries and approved Chinese visas have been cancelled as well. Confirmed coronavirus cases crossed 24,000 in China, including a one-month-old baby. Coronavirus confirmed cases in China crosses the 24,000 mark and has affected a one-month-old baby too. Coronavirus has raised its ugly head all over China and shows no signs of slowing down anytime soon. As per the statistics on Tuesday morning, the total number of confirmed cases in China crossed the 20,000 mark and stands at 20,438 as per latest reports, which includes a one-month-old baby in southwestern Guizhou province. There's an increase of 3,235 confirmed cases and a jump of over 18% from Monday. The death toll is now at 492 in China, an increase of around 65 from Sunday. China's National Health Commission spokeswoman said 80% of the victims were above the age of 60 and close to 75% had some form of an underlying condition. Coronavirus, a major test of China's governance. The people of China are looking up to its government to do more in containing the virus and provide better care for those affected by it. Chinese President Xi Jinping held a meeting with top officials and called the virus outbreak a major test of China's system and capacity for governance. The extended holidays for the Lunar New Year in China, fearing the deadly virus, is causing major economic concerns to the country, and it seems like the president is frustrated with the things happening around him. According to the Chinese state media, Xi demanded that resolute opposition against bureaucratism and the practice of formalities for formality's sake in the prevention work, and added that those who disobeyed would be punished. Xi Jinping also promised his people by calling for an improvement in the country's emergency management system and overhaul of environmental sanitation, and called for improvements to public health and a serious crackdown on illegal wildlife markets and trade. Worldwide crisis. The virus, which was first found in China, is now spreading its wings all around the world. The person-to-person transmission of the virus is now confirmed in Japan, India, Vietnam and many more countries. Visas for Chinese nationals have been rejected by almost all countries around the world and international flights going to and from China have been cancelled. Tourists, students and officials who head back to their home countries from China have been asked to undergo health checkups and many of them have been quarantined in the fear that it might spread to everyone they come in contact with.